Hello and greetings from Iceland. This is a little extra video dedicated to the enormous Katla volcano, because it's safe to say that something is going on there right now. My last Katla update was in May, and this is Katla update number 4 since February 2022. So Katla could of course be teasing us. However, the frequency of strong earthquakes only seems to be increasing, and we have to remember that Katla is long overdue. The last eruption was in 1918, and it seems to me that we are moving closer to the inevitable. And what is so unusual now is that Katla is used to tease us in the fall, after the summer has melted some of the ice, but that's no longer good enough for her. This is not the annual thing. So should they start to worry? And my brutally honest answer is, don't let this interrupt you too much. And Katla is the best guarded volcano in Iceland, and the aviation color code remains on green. And if you are a tourist in the south today, SMS messages will be sent to everyone in the area with instructions, and what we need to fear the most are the glacier outburst floods that follow. So if Katla will be acting within the known framework, everyone should be safe, but the land around will never be the same for sure. And over 100 years between eruptions is unusual, so it is hard to say what we will get this time. And I can say for myself that I would not hesitate to drive the south coast by Katla now, but a tour like I did the last year when I drove up to the glacier above the caldera, I think I would skip it this time, like things are today. And I would also skip ice cave tours, at least for 1 or 2 days until things calm down. And when we look at the statistics, the number of earthquakes annually, this is quite simple. 2021 and 2022 is just the norm. And as for 2023, we are well over 700 earthquakes already. And when we break that number down, it looks like this. So there is a spike, for sure. And those earthquakes are all over the caldera, and it seems as Mother Nature knocks on all parts of those doors that have been closed for over 100 years. But this is more and less what I have to say about this today. I do have many videos online where I cover this in depth, so it's no reason to repeat those stories. I just wanted to emphasize how unique and huge event this could be, and the security measures would be on such level before the glacier outburst flood that it will be very difficult to see this event from less than 50 kilometers away. So I still need one gadget to be able to film this from far away, or even do live broadcasts. And Katla eruption is such an event that I would throw everything else aside to witness it. From a safe distance, of course. However, I don't expect anything big to happen in the next days, although I have to admit that I had my doubts yesterday. I think it's just another milestone to the inevitable, and it is the fall that will be the risky season, since this caldera has this extremely thick layer of ice on top of it. And I'm going to try to do some more video processing while it's raining up north. But it's summer solstice now, and the north is for sure the best place for that. And there are evenings when we don't need an eruption to get shows like this. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.